Hello and welcome to this latest video from Cloudwards.net. My name is Mauricio and today I'll be taking you through a comparison between sync.com and Icedrive. There is a lot to talk about, so let's get started. But before we do, please let me remind you to give us a thumbs up if you like the video and also, of course, hit that bell if you want to be notified whenever we release a new video to this channel. Because here at Cloudwards, we're all about remote collaboration, cloud storage, file management, project management, and everything else in between. So I really hope you enjoy our content. You can browse our back catalog of over 100 videos, and I hope you'll learn something new. If you are a regular watcher of this channel or read Cloudwards.net often, you'll know that when it comes to cloud storage, we think sync.com is just the best around. It's a powerful, versatile, and secure cloud storage option that has some great pricing too. Over the years, plenty of competitors have tried unseating the king, with very few coming even close. Well, pCloud is really being the only real contender that we've identified so far. However, the last year or so, we've seen a major disruptor enter the market called Icedrive. This provider seems to be rethinking a lot of what we understand as cloud storage, taking the industry back to basics and charging a lot less than others for a stripped-down service. Where others are advertising themselves with new and fancy features, Icedrive doesn't bother and instead just charges you a lot less. We have a video review of it up, which you can check here in the card or down below in the description box if you want to know more details. However, that only suits a specific part of the market, and we figure most users do actually want all the fancy bells and whistles. Still though, we recommend everybody stick around as we go into the details of these two providers. Let's first start with pricing, as the bottom line is, well, pretty important these days, right? To start, both sync.com and Icedrive have a free plan. Icedrive gives you 10 gigabytes up front and sync.com 5, but through referring people, you can crank up your free allotment up to 20 gigabytes, which is double Icedrive's. We feel this one is a bit of a toss-up, so we'll let you basically debate in the comments which free plan is better, but I'm really, really curious to see what you guys are commenting and what's your opinion on that. As for paid plans, there's a whole lot of difference there. As you can see in this little table right here in the screen, at the top end, you are paying as much for 5 terabyte with Icedrive as you are for 4 with sync.com, which is a huge difference. It doesn't scale much better at the lower end, though sync.com's 2 and 3 terabyte plans are decent value at $43 and $40 per terabyte respectively. Though we do like Icedrive's 1 terabyte option, even if $50 is a little steep. One more thing to consider are Icedrive's lifetime plans. And sync.com doesn't offer these, but basically you pay one lump sum and if you have a set amount of storage for life, basically. Icedrive offers 5 terabyte for $500, which is a great deal. Even if Icedrive goes under in 3 years, well, you've basically made your money back. Well, here on this channel and on Cloudwards.net, we have talked a lot about lifetime cloud storage plans and we've made several videos about it. And I'm going to link you one up here and in the card and down in the description box below so you can really check out and find out if you want to take the plunge with one of the lifetime plans. We have pCloud, we have Icedrive that offer lifetime cloud storage, but obviously there's always a risk that a provider goes bust. Now, Icedrive is still pretty new. I think they have a lot of potential, but obviously, do they survive 3 years down the line? Nobody knows, basically. Still, well, as I said before, it is a bit of a risk that you're taking. But obviously, the savings when you choose a lifetime plans, they are real. They are there. However, there's one major caveat to Icedrive plans. And that is that besides the missing features, we'll get into in a second, you have to deal with bandwidth throttles. These are pretty generous. For instance, on the 5 terabytes plan, you get an allotment of 8 terabyte, but they count toward both upload and download limits. And they're hard caps too. If you are a fervent file mover, you're going to run into these caps and you may want to reconsider using Icedrive. Sync.com does not have these caps. So far, we've talked a lot about money. So now let's take the time to look at what your hard-earned moolah buys you. Icedrive has some pretty cool features, including file preview, including media files, so you can check out what you have stored before downloading or even sharing it. It also, for now, has unlimited versioning, meaning you can see past versions of a file, but this will likely be curbed in future. It also has zero-knowledge encryption, meaning only you have access to your password, which is a great security feature. However, sync.com has all this and more. Though its versioning is limited depending on the plan you're on, it adds plenty of more goodies, such as advanced sharing options, including the ability to work together on files or letting certain people edit files while others can only view, as well as one of our favorite features, selective synchronization, selective sync. This lets you choose which files in a specific folder get synced with its copy in the cloud and which don't. It's a great way to perform small backups, and it saves time, trouble, and of course bandwidth. However, when it comes to ease of use, the pendulum goes back a bit into Icedrive's favor. We simply love its sleek, minimalist approach, it's no clutter, and it's definitely the upside to having fewer features. A simple client my grandmother can use. It's not that sync.com is bad, it's just that it takes more clicks to get anywhere. Also, compared to Icedrive's, it also feels, to be honest, a little dated. So, depending on what you need in a cloud storage provider, here are two very interesting choices. One is cheaper and has a nice interface, but comes with some shortcomings because it's so basic. The other, well, costs a little more, but has more functionality and almost unavoidably a more cluttered interface. Which one do you prefer? Well, we think sync.com is the winner by a smidge, but we can see why you'd go for Icedrive too. Let's hear your picks in the comments below, and obviously thank you very much for watching, and please don't forget to like this video and subscribe. Have a good one, and see you in my next video. Bye-bye.